this video, we'll see how computers do multiplication. First, CPUs perform multiplication using an adder, a shifter, and a little program to loop the addition. But later, CPUs add a proper hardware circuit and a proper multiplication instruction. So first, CPUs had to compensate for a lack of hardware with the software. Here, we see a basic hardware to perform multiplication. We see a binary multiplier circuit for unsigned numbers. The first way to perform multiplication is using just an adder. In fact, multiplying is just adding the multiplicand to itself a certain number of times, equal to the multiplier. The Scott CPU, which I described in previous videos and which I leave the link in the description, doesn't have a multiplier circuit, and it can use, for example, the adder to perform the multiplication, but in this case you have to write a little program. This program has a loop which performs the adding instruction as many times as the multiplier. Remembering that in the Scott CPU an instruction takes 6 clock cycles, our program at least needs 6 times the multiplier clock cycle to give us the product. You can see this is a very inefficient way to perform multiplication. A better way to do multiplication is using an adder and a shifter. You can see that the binary multiplication is equal to the decimal 1, but when the digit in the multiplier is 0, you have only 0 as partial product, and when the digit is 1, you have the multiplicand replicated but left shifted as many positions as the position of the 1 in the multiplier. Then you need just to add the partial product, different from 0, but proper shifted. Scott CPU, having an adder and a shifter, can use them for multiplication, but again, it needs a little program. This program is more efficient than the previous one, but you need to do sums as many times as once in the multiplier. So, in any case, numerous instructions have to be executed. Scott's CPU, having no hardware for the multiplication, has not a simple multiplication instruction. So, let's see how we can build a simple binary multiplier. Let's see in general the multiplication of 3-bit numbers. First, I have to multiply B0 times A0, then B0 times A1, and B0 times A2. Later, we start with B1 times A0, but we shift left of 1 digit, and so on. Now that we have the partial product, we have to add them to obtain the final product. So P0 is equal A0 times B0, and P1 is equal B0 A1 plus B1 A0, and so on. So the idea is to build a circuit to obtain P0 and P1 and P2 and so on. But we have to remember that performing the addition on stage 1, we produce a carry which has to be added on stage 2, and so on. You see that the product of 3-bit number is a 6-bit number. In general, the product of 2n-bit numbers is a 2n-bit number. The circuit we are going to build is for unsigned numbers. So let's start with the least significant bit of the product, P0, and let's build a circuit to obtain it. This is easy because the product of 2 bits is obtained by putting them in AND. 1 times 1 is 1, and 0 times something is always 0. Now let's see P1. We have first to multiply and then adding the 2 factors with an alpha adder, which could produce a carry to add to the next stage. An alpha adder is a circuit which adds 2 bits. It is built using a XOR gate and an AND gate connected in this way. The XOR gives 1 if the input bits are different, but it gives 0 if the input bits are equal. So if we add 1 plus 1, we get 0 from the XOR and 1 from the AND as carry, which is 2. P2 is composed by 4 factors, so we expect the production of 2 carries. Let's see. First, we perform the multiplication. Then we start the addition with a full adder, which adds 2 factors plus a carry in, producing a sum and a carry out. The sum has to be added to the B0A2 factor with an alpha adder, producing eventually P2 and another carry out, C2. The important thing here is remembering that every carry produced has to be added to the next stage and not to the same one. In general, we use a full adder if we have to add 3 bits and an half adder if we have to add 2 bits. A full adder is a circuit like this, composed by 2 half adders. You can see, if all the bits and inputs are 1s, so we have 3, we get 1 on the sum and 1 on the carry out, which indeed is 3. P3 is composed by adding the 2 carriers produced in the previous stage to the factors in the third stage. First, we perform the multiplication, and then we see that we have 4 terms like in the previous stage, so we need just a full adder and an half adder as we did before. P4 is composed by adding the 2 carriers produced in the previous stage to the only factor in the fourth stage. First, we perform the multiplication, and then we see that we have 3 terms to add, so we need just a full adder producing a carry out, which is the P5 factor of the final product. Putting all together, we obtain the final circuit. This is a 3-bit multiplication circuit, and in comparison with the 2 previous ways, this is much faster because it is a combinational circuit, so you have only to take into consideration the delay of each gate, and the operation can be executed in one instruction. Here we replicate in CircuitVerse simulator the 3-bit multiplier we draw on paper. You can see the 6 different stages composed by AND gate and full and half adder. We put the circuit into a box for a better view. For example, this is 2 times 5 equals 10. Then here, if we change a bit in the input, we have 3 times 5, which is equal 15. The problem with the circuit is the carry propagation delay. As you can see, we don't have the final product until the carry propagates to the most significant bit. This case is just 3 bits, but think about 64-bit numbers. For this reason, there are some improving you can do, as for example the Wallace tree circuit. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.